twisted. And I never lied about anything. I never made anything up. I had an altercation with Hitmaker, Young Bird, Christian, whichever name you prefer, last night in Cancun. But what happened last night wasn't just, it didn't just start last night. You understand? What happened last night was a combination of things building up since May. What people don't know is that the real reason that Hitmaker has been just moving differently with me, and this year has just been very different. The real reason that things, our relationship has changed, is because I wanted to create Winner's Diary alone. If you all know Winner's Diary, that may be one of my most popular mixtapes or albums. When I finished my tour, I was working on my next deal. So Hitmaker is my A&R. Hitmaker is my A&R, so he oversees a lot of the things I do. I wanted to do a deal with Empire for 2 more albums. And I wanted to do Winner's Diary on my own because that's a different vibe. It's a Chicago vibe. It wasn't me pushing him out my situation. I just wanted to have control over the way the music sounded. I know my fans pick up on the different vibes in every album, and I felt like Winner's Diary 5 would be very special. And I didn't want anyone to come in and change that sound or change that energy. When I made that decision, Hitmaker literally washed his hands, as he said, washed his hands with me. Now, along with me making that decision, Hitmaker is upset because I would not pay him $2 million. So now we have a man that, number one, is upset because I want to work on my craft. And number two, is looking for money. You understand? So me being the person that I am, I had a heart. And I said, Hitmaker, hey, I don't want you to feel like I'm unappreciative or that I'm pushing you out of my situation, because I do appreciate what you do for me. And at the end of the day, we put in a lot of work, so let's keep it going. I brought him on to create Winner's Diary. But by that time, yes, ma'am, $2 million. And that's what I think people don't understand. A lot of people don't understand. I've seen videos today, women going live. I'm not going to even speak too much on the women going live because I know you have no clue who you're dealing with. And I may not be known to you, but I want you to know that I'm a multimillionaire. I don't speak on finances. I don't speak on deals or money, but I have to stand up for myself. No matter who you think I am, no matter what you think I do, my bracket is far beyond both of you guys combined. You understand? So I won't spend my time talking to y'all. Y'all are part of an entourage, and that's what entourages do. They talk from the back. They talk from the back. So tonight, I want to keep y'all in the back. You understand? So back to Berg, Hitmaker. We've been dating for a long time, very long time. I've been silent about a lot of the things that I go through behind the scenes. I've been silent about our relationship. I've been silent about us fucking. I've been silent about the deals, the money, literally almost everything you can imagine. I keep shit pee. In this situation, it's a buildup of things. It's number one, him asking me for money. Number one, him asking me for $2 million. Number two, him being upset that I want to create from my own source. You know, a man that doesn't want to see you work on your own, make money on your own, survive on your own, that's not love. You understand? So last night I was enraged. You feel me? I'm a very peaceful person, but I've been taking a lot. And the fact that I don't speak up is the reason why it seems, you know what I'm saying, so bizarre. And that's why he comes to the internet and you know, he makes his statements as though I'm a crazy bitch. And if anybody knows me, I'm more sane than him. If you know me, I'm very intelligent. You know what I mean? I'm a stand-up woman. And like I say, last night, I know that I made a mistake putting my hands on somebody. I said that in my live. I mentioned that. I'm woman enough to say that. I know what I did but I want to just explain why I did it. I feel like I've been bending over backwards for a long time. For a long time. And when somebody bends over backwards for you, when somebody tries to help you or listens to you, takes your lead, you know what I'm saying, puts the ball in your court, the very least you can do is show respect. Because that's what I've done for the past 3 years. You get what I'm saying? For the past 3 years, I've shown nothing but respect, even when shit is in turmoil, even when I'm hurt, even when I'm sad, I show nothing but respect and I work. So at the very minimum, when I see somebody in public, I had no problem with him being outside with women. I know that he's dating other women. Honestly, that's not new for him. I have no problem with that because you're not dating me right now. The least I wanted was respect. When somebody has placed $1 million in your pocket, the least I need is respect. And I wasn't respected last night. I texted him multiple times in that restaurant. I said, "You look great tonight. Go up." I was never jealous of any woman with him. I know it's me, you know, and I need people to know that the same, you know, to the women, the same nigga that y'all going to war over, he eats my ass. From the rooter to the tooter, you know, it's very different. You can't hold a candle, but it's not about you. It's more so about me and this situation, and I need people to know. That's what the real is, you know?